Hello, MechWarriors! How is it going? Welcome to your daily dose of MechWarrior Online. Today we are playing the Ibn Jaguar because I wanted to play another LB20 build, and the Ibn Jaguar is actually a relatively good carrier for that because, as you can see, the nice high hardpoint, so that's really cool. On top of it, we have 5 ER medium lasers, we have a targeting computer Mark 1, and enough heat sinks to cool the mech down. So the build itself, it is a very, very nice DPS-oriented build. We have the peaking opportunity with our ER mediums, and then when the broad is on, we just shoot our LB20 into that. We're running 4 tons of ammo, which is split a little bit awkwardly here, so make sure that you keep your right arm, because the ammo in your torso will be consumed first. And if you are in the middle of the fight, having some shots of the LB20 already fired, and then lose the right arm, and you're down in terms of ammo, and that's not good. So preserve that right arm here. That's very, very important. You could also put it into the side torso, but at the same time, I don't like that too much, because when you get crit, when there's a lot of machine gun fire right now, then, you know, it could be that the ammo goes off, because there's 4 times the chance that one of the thing gets blown off. By the way, ammo explosion, only a 10% chance, so you could gamble with that, but I didn't want to take the risk here, therefore splitting it up a little bit. The skill build looks like this. We have invested a little bit into firepower here, as you can see. We have, of course, the laser duration nodes. We have magazine capacity and LBX spread, but apart from it, not too much. Instead, we are going for survivability here. So we are kind of close range, so mid to close range. Therefore, armor is crucial. We are having a little bit of upper torso mobility. The torso speed is really nice because all of our weapons are torso mounted. Actually, not all of them. We have 2 arm-mounted weapons, but we don't have lower arm actuators, and therefore we need the upper torso mobility to actually bring all the weapons to the point where they are needed. We have operations here, because I wanted cool run. It's a no-brainer, more or less, and I'm running double cool shot here, because sometimes you need the additional DPS coming out of that cool shot, and to bring the target down, to get that kill that you desperately need before the enemy kills you. That is the build, everybody. I wish you all a lot of fun in the 2 games that are coming. Today is something special because we only play Escort, but if you enjoy them, then don't forget to leave a rating or subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And now it's time to hit the battlefield. Alright, first game of the day. We are playing Escort on the Polar Highlands. Polar Highlands Escort is so tough, guys. So, so tough, because it is such a big map and the enemy's VIP is taking very random routes, and you never know where he is gonna be, and you have to be very quick about the kills and then find the VIP, otherwise you will just lose the game through the objective as the attacker. So I think in this scenario here, we have to go in hard, like really hard, and try to find some enemies, kill them first before they kill us, and then find the VIP. Because again, when you're playing it too timid, then the VIP will just run away. I had so many games in Polar Highlands in Escort where the enemy team, or where the protecting team was just dodging the enemies, and as a result, even if they got destroyed, the VIP got away. And that's what we want to avoid, right? We want to win the game. We not only want to have a good fight, but we also want to win the game. Therefore, we have to attack, and we have to attack early, and find them. VIP that. Now let's see what we can do. We have a bunch of Orions here, look at that. The Orion brothers. We got a regular Innosphere Orion, and then two C's here. 1A and 1C. Wait, what is the C doing? Is that the double ballistic one? Is that it? Or is that the energy one? No, double ballistic. Okay, yeah. So let's try to find ourselves some targets here. And get the flags. Flags are so crucial. Oh, there they are. Is the VIP amongst them? Doesn't seem like it. Does not seem like it. Everybody is in the what's it called? Wait, what is that called? Fox 9 area. Fox 9. Oh man, the alphabet. I just. Never mind. New target. Sometimes it's hard to talk about MechWarrior things and then remembering the proper order of the alphabet, right? Okay, I'm gonna help the Shadow Cat. Really hope he's not getting shot, so that he can actually decap that. Oh, come on, stay there. I wanna help you. Low signal. Yes, we counter-capped it. That's great. That is super good. And I'm gonna push a little bit ahead now. just because I want to show my team that I am eager to push. So far there is no communication on the battlefield. I try to lay out some plan in the first phase of the game, but nobody responded. So I believe we're gonna be mostly on our own here, and we have to just do some things that motivates the team to come with us. Like, if talking doesn't work, then we have to do some actions. Okay. Oh, there's a turret. Let's kill the turret. Yeah, and see that? 25% already? New target acquired. That's what I was talking about. Okay, let's kill the Zeus Alpha, please. Alpha. Oh, there's the VIP. Yeah, we found the VIP. Cool. Now, that is really good. Hi. That was weird. I was shooting, but the shot seemed to be delayed. Or the audio seemed to be delayed. Okay. The Warhawk is crit right side. I want to get the side torso. They are super focused on what's going on there, so we're gonna quickly take this here. And then put up a UAV. Okay, I think it was worth it, going for that. It's the Zeus. Wait, we saw that guy before, right? Or is that another Zeus? Guys, be careful with your shooting. I felt like I was getting shot from the back here. That's not good. Let's punish him. We go for the Bushwhacker. Just stay on one target right now. Oh wait, this is the guy that we saw before. Too many different targets here. That's not good. We need more focus. Okay, he's down. Try to kill M. M the Zeus. What is that? Marta? No. What is the call sign for M? I don't know. We're gonna go ahead and kill our Warhawk that we saw before. The cool thing about this here is, and I mean really cool, is that the mech is, you know, cold. Come on, twist in, man. He wants to get back to second line. Okay, we got that guy. It's 4-4, but we got the VIP here. We could just kill him, probably. It was very lucky that we found the VIP so early. So, and now we separated them from their big guy. Hey, dude. Be a bit careful here. We need to get the catapult down. I believe it is a light engine catapult. Yeah, it seems like it. So now the Bushwhacker. Come on, dude. Yep. Here's the catapult. Eat level critical. Why is my team dying? Could he not die, please? We need you guys. I have a problem now. A big problem. I'm the focus of somebody else in the back, and I couldn't get to him. I couldn't retaliate. I was hoping that one of my teammates would do something about it, but no, they did not. Oh, we have a disconnected Mad Cat. Ooh, can we do it? Yeah, it's fine. It's gotta be fine. It's okay. I mean, this Orion is super crit, but we have... I'm not entirely sure if we can do it. Dude, Nigeria, there is a Jenna behind you. He will eat you alive. Yeah, right. Oh my god. Wait. Shadowcat. Shadowcat's still looking strong. Okay, so we got that guy. Zap. Yeah, kill the catapult and then the Jenna. It shouldn't be an issue, actually. In this scenario here, in this situation, we should have it in the back.
Then Penny, just get quick kills.
Come on. Kill him, please. Kill him. Please. Please. No. Get him! Oh, yeah. The other torso! That one is that has a damage reduction. By the way, if you hit the torso that is destroyed already, the damage will transfer to the adjacent component. So if you hit the side torso, which is not there anymore, then the damage will be transferred to the center torso, but only at a rate of 40%. So try to hit the center torso hitbox, or just go for the other torso, which will deal maximum damage to that torso, and when that gets off, then the mech dies because of light engine. Okay, now, where is the VIP? There he is. Oh, he's super messed up. Look at that. He already lost the side torso. And what's the ATM fire that probably popped that? Oh yeah, the Shadowcat should be able to get it. Come on, dude. There we go. Ooh, that was closer than expected, honestly. I thought, when we found the VIP, I thought it was in the back. But the fight still lasted a while, and again, the disconnect was really unfortunate. And could you see how crucial it is? We found the VIP early, but still, the dropship was already there, and it wasn't that far away from it. So, be on Polar Highland, be super aggressive when you're playing as the attacker on Escort. But anyway, we had 3 killing blows, 10 assists, we got 2 kill most damage dealt, 942 damage done, and 11 components destroyed. That's the first round. Let's go over to the next one and see how this will go down. Alright, second game of the day. We are playing Escort on the Crimson Strait this time. I really try to motivate my team going into the Charlie 5, Charlie 6 situation here. Because sitting on a saddle and waiting for something to happen is usually not fun, and therefore we're trying something different. And so far, this strategy has helped me out a ton. It was usually really good. And oh my god, the missiles. Okay. Can somebody get a flag in Charlie 5? I'm getting rained down with missiles. That is not so good. Are they still here? I don't know. Okay, let's try. Did we get it? Ah, yes, okay. So, again, you could always sit on the saddle and wait for something to happen, but you could also try to be a little bit more active. Oh my god, speaking of it, we have a lot of enemies here in Delta 6, guys. We need reinforcements. You guys on the saddle? Come over here. It's Charlie 6, Delta 5, Charlie 5. That is a lot of company that we have. Oh, did he shut down? No. No, he did not. Okay, but yeah, this is the cool thing. The fight happens here. And it happens fast. Can we get an angle on somebody? Like this guy there, the Even Jaguar. Maybe. The unfortunate thing is that I got some damage already here. Oh, hi. Yeah, I know. That is not a good spot for me to be in. But we got the reinforcements and some of us are going over to the saddle here. I like that. They're just pushing over there. That's really good. That's amazing. That's good to see. Because now we can do maybe some backstab shenanigans. Okay, that was good. That was good, yeah. Okay, you took my place now? Don't like that too much. But okay. Random fire. Okay, and I think we need to find another spot. I think we need to find another spot here. But yeah, team is coming. Team has found the VIP. Okay. On the other side there. Trying to stay on the hunchback there. Oh wait. He's pushing forward. Okay. There is ammo in my right arm. I don't want to lose that. Okay. That's the Shadow Cat. Push forward. That's great. Okay. Mad Dog down, that's good. Two shot. Leg destroyed. Hunchback down, okay. So, I think it's time to push ahead a little bit. Pushing ahead now. Where to go? Orion, scary target. Scary, scary. But he is almost down, so we're gonna try to shoot him here. We go for the Zeus next. Okay. I wish I had my UAV now. That would be so good. Can you push ahead a little bit, team?
New target acquired.
I think we got it here. I think the fight is almost over. There's a thing. Shot through that. Okay. Pretty happy with that outcome. Did we get him? Not quite.
New target acquired.
The double! The double! Did you see that, guys? Baradul has killed God Guardian of the Galaxy. God Guardian of the Galaxy has killed Baradul. Okay, but it's over now. Cool. So, guys, remember, on the Crimson Strait, if you're playing as the attacker on Escort, you don't have to wait on the saddle the whole game. You can just go ahead and flank around and have a good fight instead. And this is what we had here. So let's have a look at the VIP. That one is still defended. And I believe he has one guard dog around him. There was a mech. There was a mech somewhere here. The catapult is a super crit. Come on. Yeah, there he is. There's an Even Jaguar. Yeah. Ooh, the heavy lasers. Heavy large and medium pulse. Interesting combination. But as soon as my team comes in to the rescue, I think they got it. MRM destroyed, and there goes the catapult. So we have one Even Jaguar. He is relatively fresh with heavy large lasers and medium pulse. Let's see if my team can bring him down. I mean, the Shadow Cat running large pulses here. Mr. Direwolf. Not quite a Direwolf, but hey. The only thing is, yeah. The problem that the Ibn Jaguar has is of course his heat limit, so he cannot shoot forever. He has a very strong weapon setup, that's for sure. But he will run hot. Don't shoot TPAP, get the Jack first. Just kill the threat and then go for it. Okay, let's switch to another target. I want to see what the Shadowhawk is doing there. Wait, there he comes. Oh, Ultra 5's cool. Bap, bap. There we go. Okay, and now it's only the VIP that we need to kill. Cool. Those were really, really cool escort games here. I really like the dynamics of them. So, the Polar Highlands game and this one here. Maybe you can get something out of that. So that's your takeaway for today. On Polar Highlands, be aggressive because you are on a hard timer there. And on Crimson Strait, you don't have to wait on the saddle. Do something else. Just go around the Charlie 5, Delta 5 area and you're fine. This guy seems to have no heat sinks. Enemy dropship approaching. Come on, dudes. We can do it. Bam, bam, bam. I love that. I should play the Ultra Auto Cannon build sometime. Haven't done that in a while. Come on, dudes. Come on. There we go. Finally. Cool. Man, that double kill there. That was crazy. I think I had that only once or twice in my whole MechWarrior career, where we shot at the same time and then both mech died. Anyway, we got 2 kills here, we got 7 assists, we had 3 kill most damage dealt, 603 damage with 3 components destroyed. That's your daily dose, everybody. That was the Ibn Jaguar with the medium lasers and that LB20. And if you enjoyed the video, then don't forget to leave a rating or subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. If you want to support the channel, go down below to the description. There is the link to my Patreon page. And I hope to see you on the battlefield, everybody. Goodbye.